Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new here, welcome. Please remember to subscribe and hit the bell. Today is a very special video, one that's close to my heart. It is in honor of my 40th birthday, which just passed, which don't even get me started. I can't believe I'm 40, but that's another story. And in honor of Bell Media's Let's Talk campaign. So today is Bell Mental Health Day, and in honor of helping to talk about mental health and destigmatize mental health, I'm going to be sharing with you 40 lessons that I've learned at 40. So a lot of these things that have helped me overcome a lot of anxiety, and just little nuggets of wisdom on life, love, and spirituality. I really want to thank my spiritual mentor, Lisa Lajoie, as well as my business mentor, Nicholas Hoare, without whom I would not have the business and the life that I love today. FYI, Lisa Lajoie and I are going to be leading a yoga and spirituality retreat in Morocco, March 23rd to 30th. So I definitely think you should check the link below, check that out, and come with us to Morocco. So without further ado, let's dive in. Number one, happiness is the default. We cannot pursue happiness because happiness is already who we are. This is all over yogic and Buddhist wisdom. As Nishala Devi puts it, yoga is the uniting of consciousness in the heart. Once consciousness is steadied, we abide in our true nature, joy. Number two, gratitude is the antidote to stress. It's impossible to be grateful and stressed at the same time. Number three, I am responsible for my own happiness. So over the years, I've figured out the things that bring me closer to my true nature of joy. Things like yoga, meditation, being in stillness, and having quiet time since I'm an introvert, creative projects, traveling, all these things don't make me happy, but they certainly help to still me so that I can feel and be in touch with that true nature of joy. Number four, no one and nothing can make me miserable. This is actually really empowering. Whenever we're reacting, we're never reacting to people or things outside of us. We're always reacting to the sensations in our body. Through mindfulness, we can learn to change how we react and change our entire world from the inside out. I'll link a video about that down below. Number five, it's not the story that matters, it's how you tell it. So we all have stories, we have narratives about our lives that we tell ourselves and that we tell other people on a regular basis. And we can either be the victim in that story or the hero. Heroes rise from failures, they are resilient, they are courageous, they learn from their mistakes. And we have the choice of how we frame our narrative so that we can be the hero in our story. Number six, self-care is not selfish. I have had to learn this one and I still learn it constantly. Whenever I stop taking care of myself, I get resentful. I don't feel like I have as much energy for inspiration, for creativity. So we need to take care of ourselves and nurture ourselves so that we can be the best possible givers and nurturers to other people. As the Sufi saying goes, give from the overflow of your well, not from its depths. Number seven, you are allowed to have needs and desires. Explore those little yearnings that come to you from your heart and your soul. They are there for a reason. And make yourself important enough that you will feed your soul and follow those little nudges. Number eight, you cannot have yin without yang. So we all have periods of growth and then we need periods to rest. If we don't take the time to rest, the universe will force it on us. We will get sick, we will get burnt out, we'll get ill, anxious, depressed. So take that time that you need to rest, be still, do your yin yoga and restorative practice, meditate, whatever you need to do to find that balance. Number nine is follow your intuition. I don't know about you, but I have only ever regretted when I haven't followed it. This is a very smart little internal compass, and you can be confident about it. Number 10, this is a tough one, tell the truth. It can be absolutely excruciating to tell the truth of what's really going on to yourself and to other people, but it really will set you free. As Gloria Steinem put it, the truth will set you free, but first it will piss you off. But it's still worth it. Number 11, don't rush in. I have rushed into so many relationships without really getting to know the person first. And what I'm really falling for is not the person, but the fantasy that I have built around them. And same thing, be a little bit wary of anybody who falls too quickly in love with you, because again, they might not really know you and be falling in love with who they think you are, not who you really are. Love grows through trust, and trust is built over time. Number 12 is choose someone kind. How someone treats you and how you feel around them is much more important than how impressive their dating profile is. Number 13, you attract what you think you deserve. On the wall of my studio for 10 years, I had this quote by Yogi Bhajan, "The moment you value yourself, the whole world values you." Number 14, trust needs to be earned. So by definition, not everyone can be in your inner circle. Protect your heart, protect your dreams by only sharing with the people that you know will encourage you and love you and won't judge you. Number 15, always do your best, understanding that your best is always changing. This was a big one for me. My best changes depending on the day, whether I'm feeling healthy or sick, how much time I have, how many priorities. Just know that done is better than perfect, and good enough sometimes really is good enough. Number 16, pain is inevitable, suffering is optional. Again, I've linked my video down below for more information about that. Number 17, do not wait until you're ready. If something really excites you, do it, even if it simultaneously scares the shit out of you. As Georgia O'Keeffe said, "I have been absolutely terrified every day of my life, and I've never let it stop me from doing a single thing I wanted to do." Number 18 is to deal with the past. This is also a tough one. I know from having anxiety that there were a lot of things that I hadn't looked at, I hadn't dealt with from a long time ago. And it was only when I really asked for help that I started to be able to work through it and be able to really be held accountable for living my best life. Number 19 is that you are not alone. Whatever it is you're going through, probably someone is going through something similar. And by sharing with, again, a trusted person or two, you can get the help that you need. Number 20, it will get better. It will. Number 21, avoiding difficulties and problems usually makes them worse. So again, this goes with trying to tell the truth to ourselves and asking for help so that we can deal with the things that are in front of us and not let them get worse than they need to be. Number 22, everything is always changing. Rather than being depressing that everything changes, it actually can help deepen our sense of gratitude and presence in the good times. And it can help us have a little bit of lightness and hope in the more difficult times, understanding that this too shall pass. Number 23 is that it's never too late to change. So the only time where you can make a change for your future is now. As Buddha once said, what you are now is a result of what you have been, but what you will be is what you do now. Number 24, stop beating yourself up. Have compassion for yourself. Forgive yourself for mistakes. When we constantly beat ourselves up, it keeps us stuck in the past and really chips away at our self-esteem. So be kind with yourself. Number 25, stop looking over your shoulder. Once you've made a big decision, go for it full throttle. The single biggest determining factor of whether or not a decision ends up being successful is how dedicated and devoted you are to making it work. Number 26 is that failure is a part of success, not separate from it. You are allowed to fail and then you are allowed to succeed. You are allowed to fail and then you are allowed to rise higher and faster. Number 27, sometimes courage is knowing when to quit. Thanks for this one, Dad. But it's actually true. That mediocre relationship, that job that you're just not really well suited for, the friendships that leave you drained, all those things are okay to quit in order to make room for something even better. As Nichelle Adebi would say, the universe wants to give you wonderful things, but there's no room in your closet. Number 28, don't feel the need to give an answer right away. So my knee-jerk reaction is people pleasing. I always want to say yes. I know some people, their knee-jerk reaction is to always say no. So in both cases, just say, let me think about it, and then sit quietly with yourself. And when you give your answer, then you can be clear about it and you can be comfortable with it and at peace. Number 29 goes with number 28. Your breath doesn't lie. When you are trying to make a difficult choice or any choice, rather than asking everyone around you for their opinion, sit quietly with yourself and observe your breath. Notice the scenario that makes the breath most calm and that brings up feelings of peace or enthusiasm. That's the choice you want to go with. Like that, no matter what happens, you know you will be at peace with your own choice. Number 30, when inspiration strikes, take the first action right away. Don't wait. Number 31, treat everyone with kindness, including yourself. As the great Maya Angelou said, People might not remember what you said or what you did, but they will remember how you made them feel. Number 32, being kind is not the same as being nice. You can be kind without being a people pleaser or a doormat. You can kindly say no. You can kindly break up with someone and even fire someone with kindness. Be kind whenever possible. It is always possible. Guys, we're getting there. Number 33, show up. Show up for yourself. Have your own back. Show up for the people that you care about and show up to your dharma, your purpose in life. Show up to the miracle that is your life. Number 34, can't stop, won't stop learning. Travel, read, take courses. Ask questions, meet interesting people, do all the things that will expand your mind, expand your horizons, and this will create longevity and a really rich, fulfilling life. Number 35, it takes the time that it takes. And this is another tough one where sometimes we put self-imposed deadlines on having certain things in our life accomplished by a certain age. But when we're so busy obsessing over how we think our life should be, we are missing our actual life. As Ferris Bueller said, life moves pretty fast. If you don't look around once in a while, you might miss it. Number 36, true confidence does not boast. Some of the greatest masters I have ever met, the greatest teachers, are so humble, and yet they are totally steadfast in who they are and in speaking their truth. Real confidence doesn't put you above or below anyone. It recognizes that we are all one. Number 37, nobody's life is perfect. Just keep that in mind next time that you're scrolling on Facebook or Instagram. Do not compare your behind the scenes with other people's highlight reels. This is a quote by Pastor Stephen Furtick. Number 38, life is a practice. So as a wise friend told me as we were walking down the beach in Costa Rica, if we were meant to figure it all out so fast, we wouldn't live so long. I really believe that we're on this earth school to learn certain lessons in the perfect time, in the perfect way. Number 39, ask yourself what you want your legacy to be. How do you want to be remembered? When in doubt, love. And here we are, guys, finally, number 40, which is surrender. Let go of trying to control every little thing in your life. Just let go. Have faith in something greater that is guiding you. Let go and surrender your fears, your doubts, and insecurity up to something higher. So there you are, guys. There were actually so many more lessons. Oh my God. At first I was like, how am I gonna share 40 lessons? That's so many. And now I'm like, wow, I really need 40 more and maybe 1,000 more. There's so many lessons to learn in life, but I hope that these particular ones were helpful for you. Please leave me comments below. Let me know what some of your big life lessons have been. It'd be great to share about this on Instagram and in the comments on YouTube. I'd love to hear about that. So again, I'm leading a retreat at the end of March with my teacher Lisa Lajoie, from whom a lot of this wisdom comes from, and I would love you to join us if you want to take your life to the next level. Until then, have a wonderful week, and let's talk. Let's overcome mental health stigma together. You can join the Bell Media campaign, which is also linked down below. Namaste.